Get ready to match the star. Shawty Johnson. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Hyman. From Busting Loose, Barbara Bowles. Richard Dawson. And Patty Deutsch. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers.
Thank you for joining us. Here are the beautiful people. Busting Loose, eh? You made a Neil Simon movie, right?
Oh, yes, I did.
What's it called?
It's called The Goodbye Girl.
Is it finished?
Yes.
No, I'm Swedish.
I had to stop and think for a moment, but I think it is, yes.
It'll be out soon? 4 or 5 months, something like that?
I think so.
Editing now?
Yes.
Okay.
Marsha Mason, you know?
Oh, yeah, Marsha Mason.
Richard
yeah.
Dreyfuss?
Richard Dreyfuss?
Yes.
He's married to Richard Dreyfuss, isn't he?
Marsha Mason?
No, Neil Simon.
No.
No, Richard Dreyfuss.
Married to one of them, isn't he?
Yes, he's married to Marsha.
That's what I thought, right. Thought you could trick me, eh? No. Say hello to Linda Reese over here. Applause, applause, applause. How much money have you won?
Won nothing.
Oh, you won the game. Right, you won the game.
Right.
And now you're going to try for the big amount of money.
Right.
Over $5,000.
Over?
Ready for it?
Ready.
Don't be nervous.
No.
You're not nervous, are you?
No.
No. She's okay. She's going to win a big bundle of money here, we hope. Come back and find out. This lady will try to win over $5,000 here. $5,500 is if you go to the maximum amount. That's what you could do. Good luck to you, Linda. Here we go. We had a bunch of people here in the studio audience one day not too long ago, above average intelligence like these. And we put it to him this way. We said, give us your best answer to this. Oh, got you there. Blank motion. And Linda, you, if you match their most popular answer, will get $500. For matching the second most popular answer, you get $250. Then $100 for matching the third. And whom do you call on for some help?
Barbara.
Oh, I have three. How about Perpetual?
Perpetual motion.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Richard? Have another one.
Slow motion. Okay.
Artie.
I had man in motion.
Man in motion.
Yes, football term, you know.
Right.
You see,
do understand.
I told you, baby,
you didn't.
If you wore the same string of pearls,
going steady,
nobody
you know.
Would recognize you. We wouldn't get called on.
They're
Siamese twins. There's the shot, right. The Siamese twins.
No, this is the unisex weak movement, and Brett and I are in charge.
I see. If you're going to wear pearls, Charles, you've got to wear the basic black.
Take it off, sweetheart.
Cool it. Now, you have a choice of three, Linda. Man in motion, perpetual motion, or slow motion. Do you want one of those, or do you have a better idea?
I do. I want slow motion.
Slow motion is what she chooses. Oh. Richard's answer, we'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin down at the bottom, and we will reveal the $100 response. Perpetual is one that was given to you by Barbara. All right, let's see if we get slow motion onto the next one. Go. Locomotion.
What does that mean?
Locomotion. It's
mad
a word.
Mad motion.
Oh, I'm person
local. Slightly
Spanish
mad.
Word for crazy.
All right, last chance for slow motion. Here we go. Yes, we got it. Congratulations. Very good. You pick up another $500, and you play for 10 times that amount now, or $5,000, and you have to match one celebrity to collect.
Yes, Richard.
Richard who?
Right.
Oh, Richard Dawson. That's the one you want. All right, here we are. Good luck to you, Linda Reese. Worth $5,000. This is it. Reads as follows. Ounce of blank. Ounce of blank. Linda, he's made up his mind. You make up yours. Give us the answer. Get your ESP going over to Richard. Give us the answer he's given us.
I can only think of ounce of prevention.
Ounce of prevention. Well, if you thought of it, you'd get
that's
the money.
Okay.
All right, ounce of prevention.
I had no idea at all. I swear, I couldn't think of one definite thing. I said ounce of gold.
Oh. Ounce of gold. What else is there?
Anybody know?
Ounce of prevention.
Ounce of
ounce
grass.
Of ounce of grass, no, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Linda, would you like to meet another player?
Yeah.
All right, let's bring him on. Here comes Sue Williams. Hello, Sue. Got a boy and a merry-go-round. You two ladies know each other?
Yes,
we do.
Yeah.
Sue, we welcome you.
Thank you.
Where are you from?
I'm from Grand Rapids, Michigan.
Grand Rapids, Michigan.
Yes, sir.
Are you vacationing here?
Yes, we are. My husband, Tim, and my son, Tyler, and I have been here for 2 weeks, and we brought a little bit of rain, but we've had a lot of sunshine.
Well, you've been very welcome if you brought the rain with you.
Yes.
What are you doing for laughs around Los Angeles and vicinity?
Well, we've been visiting a lot of friends. We've been traveling up and down the coast.
Got funny friends, huh?
Yeah, we sure do.
Yeah, you walk in, you're not going to... Hello? That's the way it is there. Well, Sue, anything else you want to tell us about you?
Well, I'm going to have a baby in July.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yes, you are indeed. What's the date of the show?
Let's have a baby.
June.
The 10th of June.
10th of June. Okay, we're safe. All right, Sue, good luck to you. Here we go. You may have A or B.
I'll take A.
A for baby. Okay. Conway the convict said,
"Oh, food in this prison is so bad. The prison chef doubles as a prison blank. That's how bad the food is. Food in this prison is so bad, the prison chef doubles as a prison blank.
That's how bad the food is.
That's how bad the food is.
Would you like to read this or just take it to the cashier?"
That's a good one and a very easy one.
Sure.
Oh, yeah, there's one outstandingly terrific answer.
Do you
just think about it.
Could we ask Sue
Conway the convict.
Yeah. Could we ask Sue if she has a sexual preference in her baby?
Either a boy or a girl.
What do you want, a boy?
Well, we have a boy, so the pressure's off. It can be either one.
All right.
Hope it's a girl.
May I have the question, please?
No, I'm sorry.
Are you ready?
Window 5.
Where do I get my driver's license? You didn't stamp the right thing there. Everybody ready? Almost. Sue, I'll talk to you while they're finishing up over there. Conway the convict said, the food in this prison is so bad, the prison chef doubles as a prison blank.
Garbage man.
Garbage man. Prison chef doubles as a prison garbage man.
That
what she said.
That was not the answer you
said. No, not the way it's either.
No.
What do you say?
I hope all the people in that area don't think as she does, because I'm doing a play up there this summer, you know.
We are?
Yes, in Flint and in Traverse City, Michigan.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, but I thought executioner.
Executioner would be my choice as the definitive answer.
Well, you heard him cheering.
Yeah.
Yes, they really went rampant
right.
for me.
What do you say?
What's the name of
there
the
may be a better one than that.
Give the answer.
I'm sorry. I said hangman, which is like an executioner.
That's right. That might have matched if she had said executioner.
If they want a slow death, they give them the soup.
Right.
And if they want to kill them off fast, they throw a sausage their way.
Right.
The executioner.
Executioner.
Like the ones we had for lunch about a half an hour ago.
Oh, yeah.
Like rocks.
I stayed away from those. I didn't touch those. Conway the convict said, the food in this prison is so bad, the prison chef doubles as the prison... Oh,
far be it for me to mess up this Zippo score. Garbage collector.
Oh!
Well, look at
that. She said
girl.
Garbage collector.
She also said, far be it from me, didn't
yeah,
she?
Yes, she said it again.
You know, Brett, I think you should wear a green T-shirt. I don't know.
Now, Brett isn't tall enough.
Yes, sit up straight and eat your oatmeal.
I did.
Have eaten your oatmeal. And you ate a lot of it. What do you say, Richard?
Far be it from me. Garbage man.
Oh. Don't expect too much, Sue. You got two. Don't get greedy, Sue. Hello, Patty.
Yo.
I suspect as much.
I said Johnny Mopper.
Now, I suppose you're wanting us to say, what does that mean?
No, I was hoping you wouldn't say that.
I'm going to say that.
A toy decoy.
Oh, all right. Okay. All right. So there we are in the middle of round one. She got two, and we'll see how you do right after we see about this. Let's finish round one, shall we, Linda? All right, here we go. Everybody plays. Did you hear the terrible news from down in the orange groves?
Yeah, no. I heard that. Read the question.
All right, I'll tell you about it.
Depress me, I don't want to hear it.
They just discovered that drinking orange juice makes you blank. Oh. Bad news from the orange groves. They just discovered that orange juice makes you blank. Yes, sirree.
What is that?
Terrible news from down in the orange groves. They just discovered that drinking orange juice makes you blank.
I love this question.
Oh.
Yes.
All right. Now, Linda, have you been thinking about it?
Yeah.
All right, think carefully now. I'll read it slowly one more time while they're finishing writing. There's terrible news from down in the orange groves. Just discovered.
Wait, Gina.
I'm ready. Okay, go, baby, go.
Oh, the two dingbats. Yeah. They're always late. Oh. Just
wait
discovered.
A minute, I got a better one. Oh, no.
No,
that's no. Okay, we'll go with C, Gene. Go right
okay.
ahead.
Okay. Are you quite ready?
Yo.
They just discovered that drinking orange juice makes you blank.
Sterile.
Sing out, sing it.
Daryl.
Okay.
That's what I was going to put.
Oh, really? What did you put, Artie?
Well, I originally started out and I thought it makes you look like Anita Bryant. And then I thought, well, that won't be happy. So how about makes you gay?
Gay. Hoosier gay. All right.
Wait a minute. Gay. And or frivolous. Or any other adjective of that ilk.
That's what I meant.
I got the idea. I refuse to answer questions about Anita Bryant. Well, now wait a minute, Charles. You don't have to answer the question, but you have a public forum here. Would you like to say a few words about Anita Bryant?
Who?
Heel.
Heel. Orange juice makes you peel. Are you getting the catch of it now, Linda? Do you get the drift of it?
Still yeah, it's understand. Drifting all different directions.
You don't understand. Have you seen all the newspapers about Linda Anita Bryant?
Oh, yes.
Oh, okay. Does understand it. It just didn't come to her in the nick of time, did it, Barbara? The terrible news in the orange grows. I just discovered that drinking orange juice makes you...
It came to me. Gay.
Gay. And...
Well, that's the saying, isn't it? A gay without sunshine. I said gay.
Well, it's the same thing, isn't it?
Oh! Thank you. Now you, thank my you. Dear.
I said look and think like Anita Bryant.
Look and think like Anita Bryant. All right. There we go. So it's 2-0 at the end of round one. Round two coming up. And, Sue, you may have A or B.
We'll take B this time.
Oh, you want B?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Connie the co-ed said, this is Connie the co-ed speaking, Sue. She said, in Professor Smith's class, when I want to get his attention, I don't raise my hand, I raise my blank. You don't play? You don't play.
Gee, that's really a hard one.
Let me see.
Right.
Why do you say right?
Right. Well, because it looks pretty good to me.
You know, we just lost Dade County.
We just lost Dade County?
Yes.
No, we didn't. Charles is still writing.
Well, I'm still angry at the last question.
Sue. Connie the co-ed said, in Professor Smith's class, when I want to get his attention, I don't raise my hand, I raise my blank.
My skirt.
My skirt, she said. She has this cute little dimple on her knee.
Is that right?
That's right.
You asking me if I have a...
You have a dimple on your knee?
No, but I have an orange hidden away somewhere. How about skirt?
Skirt is very good. She's up to 3 now. And we're up to you, Brett.
She has dimples other places, too, but we can't go into that.
No.
I said skirt... which are just above my Bobby socks. which dates me, doesn't it?
Yes, it do. Indeed it do. Why are you looking so wide-eyed?
Well, because ever since we left the dressing rooms, I said green busted T-shirt.
Green busted T-shirt. Oh. Oh, I see.
It doesn't look broken to me, Charles.
It would have been a match if yes. White was on.
Right.
Sit up straight.
I am. Oh, is that the best you can do? I see. Now, Daddy, we're up to you.
Far be it from me. Skate.
There it is. So you've got five. And you get ready to go to work, but first we've got to do a little work for you. Pay attention. All right. Shall we finish this game? You know what you have to do, Linda?
A lot.
You have to match five to tie. You could match all six, though, and win it. Everyone plays. When Mr. Taylor took Tom's taxi, he didn't tip Tom. The next time Taylor took Tom's taxi, Tom took Taylor and tossed him into the blank.
Trying to forget the letter T and you come up with this?
Taylor took Tom's taxi and tipped Tom.
Wait a minute, I have a
question. I was going to be funny, but I'd rather not be funny. I'd rather be right once in a while. I'm tired of being.
That's good.
You haven't been funny or right all day.
Leave him alone. I've noticed your handwriting. You've been writing in Arabic all afternoon and lying about your answers.
To say nothing of my age.
Do you understand?
Well, that's starting to show.
Very simple. Here we go. What can I do for you, Linda? Have you thought about it? I'll read it one more time while Charles is writing. When Mr. Taylor took Tom's taxi, he didn't tip Tom. The next time Taylor took Tom's taxi, Tom took Taylor and tossed him into the blank.
Toilet.
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 Okay.
John, toilet.
Tossed him into the toilet, she said. What do you say?
I know he wanted to say
toilet and he threw it out. He said, well, I didn't
want
to be a smart head.
That's right. I said trunk.
Trunk is a good answer. Now you got to match everybody else to stay in the game. Linda, here we go. Brett.
Now listen to this. In New York, they don't say toilet.
What do they say?
They say churlet.
Churlet. So that's one for her. All right.
Another word for jail. Tossed him into the tank.
Tank. So that means Sue Williams wins the game. All the rest of you have. Joydy, John, Joydy. You missed it by one. Come on. All right, we congratulate you, and you hang around there on the blue spot. And we're going to shake this pretty lady's hand. She's going to leave here with what, $600?
Right.
That ain't bad, Linda. Congratulations
you.
To you
Thank
for being with us here on Match Game 77. Whoops, you dropped an earring. Yes. All right. What do you say we stand here head-to-head and talk? Or do the best we can. All right. Listen, you're okay, my dear. You got $100. You could win over $5,000. Sue, here it is. Big board here, all for you. We polled a recent studio audience and we said, give us your best response to this. Pip blank. $500 for their most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third, and three celebrities can help.
I'll take Richard.
Pip squeak.
Pip squeak is one.
And Charles?
What do you say, Chuck?
Well, Gladys Knight, just S. Pips.
Pips.
And Brett?
Now, just a minute. Something might be coming.
Don't count on it, sweetheart.
What?
It's an English expression.
Stand up and give it to her.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, Pippin.
Pippin, Broadway show, written by my friend Roger Herson. Pippin.
Oh, Roger would love to hear
that. Yes, based on the Charlemagne's son named Pippin. Yeah. Let's see if we get. Now, you want Pippin, you want Pips, or you want Pipsqueak?
I'll go with Richard and Pipsqueak.
Yes. Pipsqueak. All right, let's see if we got one up there. May we see the $100 number? Pip-a-roo.
That's Hip-hip-a-roo.
No. That's Pip-a-roo.
Pip-a-roo. May we see the $250 number?
Pip-pip.
We had a bunch of weirdos in here that day, I tell you that.
Where did they get it?
Pip-a-roo. Indeed. Listen, you're not counting on this money, are you, son?
Don't worry about it.
All right. May we see the $500 number?
Wait.
Oh!
Don't touch
the bait. Very good. So we got to stop right here, don't we? All right. Just hold everything, put everything in cold storage here for a second or two while we do a little business with America. Next time we get together, these are the bodies you'll see on this very same stage.
Avery Schreiber, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Harris, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flyer.
Wonderful! You made it in 1977.